2016's a funny year because this would be when Marvel vs. Capcom comes back, when it actually returns. There's a lot of neat stuff that happens. The funny enough, like, Injustice 2 is about to be announced, and it feels like Mortal Kombat X just came out. But at this point, MKX will have been around for about a year, getting close to about a year. But still, playing Marvel 3, playing KI, playing Third Strike, playing MKX, playing some random X-Men versus Street Fighter online, and also playing the betas of Street Fighter 5 around this time frame. In the background at this point, I'm also working on Season 3 of KI, a few trailers, not all of them. I'm working on the story mode, the new story mode in Killer Instinct, which is like the Conquest Gargos mode. Oh, the Killer Instinct Top 8 World Finals happens for KI Cup. This ends up being super sick because I was like hosting it over in San Antonio.
He was doubting himself, his ability.
And it was a great... Well, it was a super fun tournament. It was a cool tournament, man. This was like the first big Killer Instinct World Cup, and I was the host of the thing, so I had to make sure people were happy. But my God, man, I was like running around and doing a whole bunch of stuff. So the other fun thing that happened in this time frame was the Street Fighter Legacy, and I really enjoyed this one because there's a shit ton of Street Fighter games, like an absolute shit ton. And going through each and every one of them was actually really fun. The EX games, all the weird ones in between. We sort of revisited a couple more times in the future just because I like going through some of those games with characters, like the Ken Legacy and the Sakura Legacy and even the Akuma one when those characters were coming back. Alien comes out for Mortal Kombat 11. That ends up being a pretty big deal. The final season of Mortal Kombat X happens. And then, yeah, Dark Souls 3 comes out around this time frame, and I was pretty jazzed for that game. I can't think of anything that was too crazy around this time frame, other that in the background, right after I was done working on the season 3 story stuff, I was working on the next big ass movie. And Alien is a huge, huge undertaking that I was not ready for. If I thought the Predator, or if we thought the Predator thing was gonna be crazy, the Alien movie is way, 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 way crazier. But yeah, a lot of Killer Instinct. Killer Instinct's kind of in its prime right now, and Season 3 was changing a lot of the game, and that was very fun. And then we had our Alien teaser.
It's game over, man. This Saturday at 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, Twitch and Yo Video Games present a live stream event. Assist me, Alien. They're coming out of the goddamn walls.
So we were trying to hype everyone up for it. The problem with Alien Assist Me was that people already knew the gimmick, right? People already know the gimmick of Jason. People already know the gimmick of the Predator movie. And the Predator movie just went bigger and crazier. So we had to come up with a completely unique gimmick that would surprise people in a way that was different than the other movies. And that was like the biggest challenge, but it also was some of the most fun because we were hyping people up at this point. I think even in this video, I do the same thing. So I was actually pitching to people that this is a live, like, studio sort of event.
It's kind of hard for you to figure out what's happening live and what's not happening live, and that's kind of the thing that Assist Me has turned into at the moment.
The idea was that we were telling people that it was going to be like a live event because that was the setup. We want people to think that we're making a movie. We want people to think that we're making a giant production, that it's expensive and it's insane, so that we can twist that immediately after. Is anything else around here before we jump into this crazy shit? I don't think so. Let's just talk a little bit about the Aliens movie. So this
film was an
whole thing is to build people up that this is a big, insane live movie event, and that's what we wanted to do.
Pre-recorded. All you need to
there
know
was no surprise anymore. We knew we couldn't surprise people with anything. So the gimmick at the beginning of this thing is that we have like a sponsor for Lost World's laser tag, which is just some like, what the hell is that? It's a fake sponsorship that goes, that is tied into the story of what needs to happen with our characters here. We play some games and it's all taking place live, and our movie is about to start. This is our movie. Cost us millions of dollars, we told people. It cost us so much money. So this was everyone's like, it's happening, here's the movie. We've been waiting for this. So yeah, we finally get to see what Max has been talking about, this million-dollar production.
I'd like to keep this handy for close encounters.
Cell phone time. Yeah, whatever it is. I'll find it.
Another bug hunt. I was born for this.
We don't want it to feel completely stupid, just goofy. It still feels like it's a cheeseball assist me movie. But we're definitely having fun with it. I felt betrayed. And here was our alien in all of its majesty. And I remember reading in the chat at this point, some people are like, huh. Thought the alien would look better. Thought the alien was gonna look a little bit better. JJ was responsible for making the mask and the suit and everything.
Why are we all afraid? We got guns! Yeah! Guns! Let's waste this motherfucker!
And that's our fake movie. People at the end were like, huh, I think I liked Predator more. So many people were like convinced. Everyone was like, huh, I thought it was okay. I think Jason was a little better, right? Yeah, Predator was better. And then people are like, what the hell? What am I? Huh? What are we? Wait, what the hell? Is it still going? Chat was so confused at this point. Wait, what? Is the movie still happening?
Looks like we need him.
What the hell's going on? I think it starts to hit about this time.
Hey, Dad.
That...
What?
Wait a minute, is this the movie? So we set up our characters, we set up a scenario. Benny's in the background. He's working on something.
What's up?
Oh.
And, now we begin the actual movie.
Jeez, splice!
So people are like, oh god, they have to save Simmons.
Are you okay?
Oh dude, I totally found my keys.
People in the chat are like freaking out for Simmons at this point. It's a dick with teeth.
Hey guys! What's going on? Why are y'all gloomy?
Xbox Live is down.
Huh. Why don't you switch over to PSN?
Hi guys!
Yes, so.
Then it switched back to this is live now. When we switch the camera.
Oh, thanks, alien child all right. Support payments. I'm gonna
yeah, so
and then the chat was donating all these funny ass things. We set up our fake sponsor again.
Movie again. Come on, guys.
Yeah.
Because we need a place for the end of the movie to actually take place. The alien sees our sponsored video. And here's that the queen is at Lost World's laser tag. Now we have a place for everybody to go.
Dad, Kenny dissed you, didn't he? Because you're always ditching us, right? Yeah. How's that feel now?
Unnecessarily evil. You can see some fun-ass lighting I got to do in here. This was so much fun to light. My god, man. To get just this shot to look the way it is, there's a light over here casting this, this glare off of the microwave. These candles are meant to represent the light that illuminates, me when I walk in here. But there's a light right over here as well. There's two people holding lights over here. They're all these tiny little handheld LED lights. This took a long time to make the alien look cool here. But there's four people around the alien at any given time lighting it. Just making sure the alien has got the correct lighting. So there's people over here, there's people back here, there's a person down laying on the floor. I think Kenny was laying on the floor shooting light up to get a fill light.
Max, come on man, it's gonna be dangerous. And it's gonna be, I don't wanna say better, but safer if you just stay here. play some video games.
Motherfucking! Okay, that's fine, buddy. Sure, yeah, okay.
That went good.
So Mike's on his way to go find the guys, and I go back to the room, and this goes back to live footage here, and this is all improv. The gag is now that I'm going to go play somebody online, but I'm going to be super salty. I'm going to act the saltiest I possibly can, just overbearingly, because I'm incredibly pissed off in character space now.
Why are they even here if they're all
This was all
bad?
Live and not
like every time
I'm just I like you know what I know exactly what I'll do.
I'm the one that's good at video games.
If I didn't have to worry about the chat room right now, this wouldn't even be a problem. Watch this combo. Son of a bitch. There's so much lag.
No, not like this.
Maybe you just need to get good. Maybe all of you just need to get good. You dirty, low tier, no fundamental bitch.
I never thought I'd live to see the day. Scrub Lord 2.0.
Foolish, Benny. Now you will die.
It's so much fun. This shot right here is all done in editing. The gun never actually illuminated with numbers, so I shot the gun on the ground, filmed it, and then went into post and just designed, like, the numbers. We had to have, like, a countdown. There had to be, like, something to tell people that they're almost out of ammunition. The shaking, all of this is fake. It's all completely fucking fake. I did it in post. I just tried to make it look real. I'm proud of it, because no one, until I say it, no one thinks about it. And I think we had this idea very late. There was one moment where we were walking back and someone mentioned something about, like, the Predator. I immediately went like, oh my fucking God, how did I not? It immediately hit me and I was like, the Predator should save him. Like, how the fuck did we have the alien and the Predator not fight in this and we have a Predator costume? I felt so stupid that we wrote this whole script. And we came up with the idea on, like, right before we went out. Like, it was super fun. I mean, it was my dream movie. We got to make a Predator movie. We got to make an Alien movie. I loved it, man. And yeah, if it happened around May, then we really started planning this thing around December. Because we heard about the alien showing up in Mortal Kombat, and I was already like, oh, we have to. We just have to. There's no way we can't do that. In comparison of, like, big movies, this was a 52-minute movie. Like, a full fucking movie that we made. And nothing really crazy happened at the beginning of 2016. Most of 2016, like, big project-wise, there wasn't a lot of boss rages, there wasn't a lot of, like, other stuff. And that's because I was working my ass off on the Alien movie, dude. I spent a lot of time on that script and figuring out character motivations and trying to write dialogue for everyone that felt very natural so that people didn't feel out of character. That was a very, very challenging part for me, was just making like a script where you like the characters, right? Where the characters are fun and enjoyable throughout the whole thing. So, yeah, a lot of Mortal Kombat. This funny-ass moment happens. My Xbox dies live on stream. It's very sad, but it's also sort of the beginning of me taking stream moments instead of just, like, general gameplay. I was taking moments from the stream and throwing it into little, like, story compilations up on YouTube.
What the fuck? What the fuck? What is going on?
Time over.
That was the actual music. Oh! Here's a big one. I edit my first video for E3. Microsoft approaches me. They're like, we want to get you some capture equipment to record something in 4K. We need to make a trailer for E3 for Killer Instinct. I'm like, holy shit. I get to make a trailer for E3 for, like, the Microsoft press conference. They're like, we have 15 seconds approximately. We have, like, 15 to 20 seconds. I'm like, what? And all I knew about General Rom was that he stabs a bitch, right? That's, like, the most iconic thing. And I don't have time to show off a lot of his gameplay. So I'm like, you know what? Let's just focus on, like, one moment with General Rom showing up in KI. and they were surprisingly cool with it. So I had a very, very limited time budget, and this is what I came up with.
Shapewear makes me feel really confident and cinched in, but comfortable.
There you go. I hope you guys liked it. I'll see you next time. Here's the trailer now. I'll never be able to live up to that one. And that was all I had. It was much longer than 15 seconds, but I think there was much shorter versions that they cut for some parts of E3. And that was it. That was my final, that was one of my final trailers for KI. The damn Resident Evil reaction. I completely predict that this game is Resident Evil 7.
Resident Evil 7.
Even the Capcom people, when they were at E3, was that they were laughing their asses off at this reaction video. My God, man, I haven't watched this in a long time.
Did you know Third Strike's the worst Street Fighter game? It's horribly unbalanced and takes no skill to win.
I forgot about this.
You dirty, scrubby dog! Wouldn't know a good fighting game if I hit him in the ass! Have you ever been top 8? Shut the hell up!
They made this for Evo, actually.
You're in for a treat. But tonight, you will get good.
It'd be funny if these came back. He's essentially Dr. Disrespect. I realized that. I didn't even know who Dr. Disrespect was in 2016. You also know why this didn't continue, because once again, chat, I have a lot of ideas and not a lot of time. And that's the problem, is I want to make these shows and I really love these shows, but they are time consuming.
Well, that was fast, Benny. Here, let's see what you got.
Holy shit! Where did you find that?
In the closet, Max. I buried it in the closet.
No, no. I destroyed it. No one should ever be allowed to
play it. It's the best fighting game ever.
Ever?
You promised you'd play it for your son, Benny.
Yeah, fighting history is, like, once again, just a show that I had wanted to do for so long, right? Like, I came up with the idea and, like, planning for it in 2014, and guess what happened in 2014? Got hired to work on Killer Instinct. So, this is it, right here. Yeah, the first day of Anime Saturday on stream. The very first one.
Tenshin Muyo! Yeah!
This just happened naturally on stream. There was no plan. Taco Tai.
This is getting ridiculous right now.
I love it. I love the little tears and sparkles.
The Tai-Pod made that.
Oh my God, man. Fucking dying here.
That was definitely one hell of a some stream. The most I actually play of Street Fighter V online, somebody makes me a very well-known modder in the modding community for Street Fighter, made me a costume in SF5 for Ken. Yeah, he actually made me a mod of Ken. Let's see if we get a shot of it.
I thought you're scared. Here we go.
And it was like, you know what? That's so cool. And I don't like Ken a lot in this game, but that's so sick that I'm going to play through Street Fighter V all the way and get to platinum. Fighting History Thrill Kill. I really like this episode. This is, I had a lot of fun doing this, and this is a weird fighting game with a very interesting story.
The game has 4 attack buttons, a block, and a crouch button.
This game is some, this game is on some shit, dude. The game's actually kind of interesting, which is weird. It's just that it's so tone deaf in like every way that it would never get released.
It's Ryu and Ken. But Ken has Ryu for a dick and a dick for a head. What the fuck?
I will never forget the day. I was on a trip to Thanksgiving to families up north, and I heard about Marvel vs. Capcom 4. We already psycho-predicted what the hell was gonna happen. We already psycho-predicted that this shit was gonna take place. Akuma is in Street Fighter V, and this starts the Akuma legacy. And I think the Akuma legacy is one of the most successful legacies I've ever done. Oh man, and the Akuma boss rage. This was once again a inadvertent boss rage. I wasn't planning on doing one, and it sort of just happened. But it's a fun one, and the best part's actually at the end.
Let's go, bitch!
That was what I wanted the most. I wanted that. That was like the vision I had was like, oh my God, I killed him with the demon. I'm going to set up this moment where Akuma, because we're doing the Akuma legacy, goes through a bunch of different versions of the demon and just murders him. And then, yeah, one of the last videos of the year, 2016. This is the first time I do the top moments from the stream is in 2016. And then the Star Wars fighting history. Has a lot of really good moments and scenes that I'm really happy with because we cover Star Wars The Masters of Tereskasi.
Wait, where the hell's the Dreamcast?
I did find a bus ticket to Canada last week.
Canada? Where the hell would it go?
Oh, what's this? A Dreamcast, huh? I have something you're going to love.
That's great. I forgot we got Matt to do that for us.
Benny, I can't do this without you.
Worry not. I'll be on the bed if you need me.
Benny!
I said I'll be on the bed.
It's so sad. Funny enough, these episodes of Fighting History, when they came out, they weren't that popular. And, I was sort of like miffed by that because these things take a lot of effort and they take a lot of time. And just seeing once again that the things on the channel that take kind of low effort were doing just so much better. And that was a big thing for me in 2016 was that a lot of these very large projects like Predator movie and then the Alien movie, 4 or 5 Fighting History episodes, and then the crazy Get Good idea and stuff of that nature, people just weren't as interested. But funny enough, as the years have gone across, it seems that like Fighting History sort of picked up. There was like a resurgence. It actually found some pretty decent viewership. Yeah, I think 2016 was actually pretty dope. I think of all the years of me putting out content, probably 2016 was one of the ones that I put the most man hours and effort.